Talk about anti-Markovnikov halogenation of alkenes. So alkenes yield alkyl halides on the less substituted carbon in the presence of a peroxide initiator and hydrobromic acid. And so if we look at what that looks like here with a terminal alkene, we can add our reagents, HBr and hydrogen peroxide will do. We get substitution to the anti-Markovnikov position. So Markovnikov means more substituted carbon of the alkene. That would be HBr addition and dichloromethane with no peroxide initiator. But with the peroxide initiator, we go to the anti-Markovnikov position. We only have one more reaction that substitutes at that position, and that's hydroboration oxidation. We've seen that in a previous chapter. And so we've now got a new tool that we can use to make less substituted alkyl halides now instead of alcohols. So when is this useful? Well, when other alternatives prove ineffective at functionalizing this position. So if we take a look at propane and we halogenate this with chlorine and light, the major product, if we do the calculation, comes out to be the secondary alkyl halide, because we've got six ways to make the primary times odds of one versus two ways times odds of 3.8 for that reaction, and that gives us 7.6 versus 6 total. And so the major product will be the secondary, because the total here, 7.6, is greater than 6. So we're going to end up substituting that secondary position, even with chlorination of a somewhat symmetrical molecule in propane. So again, the odds just aren't in our favor here. So why don't we do better? Let's get a higher yield at the secondary position by using bromine instead. Follow that up. So this will be a greater than 90% yield. Follow that up with an elimination reaction with tert butoxide. That is a bulky base, so it is a good strong base and a poor nucleophile. So we get an E2 reaction and a high yield. Well, then we can turn around and use our new reaction, HBr and peroxide, to very highly percentage-wise functionalize that less substituted position. So a sequence of three reactions then gives us that major product and an excellent overall yield compared to what we'd be looking at otherwise. Looking at the mechanism, we only need to include the steps that lead to the formation of the major product. But if we do others, that's fine. We just make sure that we've got these at minimum. If we look at the initiator, peroxide, room temperature is enough. Gentle heating, if you need to, is enough to initiate the peroxide bond breaking. And so what we get is two hydroxyl radicals that form from none here in the initiation step. When we propagate this radical, one radical to the other, we're going to take our HBr and we are going to form a bond making water, H2O, homolytically break the HBr bond, again making that water molecule byproduct here, and then a bromine radical that we're going to use. Another propagation step with that bromine radical is the key mechanistic step here that sets our regiochemistry anti-Markovnikov. The secondary radical is more stable than the primary, so when that alkene pi bond breaks to form the radical, see if I can get that tidied up there, so the secondary radical forms, simultaneously functionalizing that anti-Markovnikov position. A third propagation step sets our product by taking the HBr that's still in solution. We've got an excess here. And then forming our product plus another bromine radical that can continue to do the work of the reaction. So we've at least got the formation of our product here in our reaction. For a termination step, we've got a lot of options. None of them lead directly to our product. There is a byproduct that we could look at that does a dihalide formation, just like we would see in chapter 6, except it's not an anti-addition. We get mixed stereochemistry with this compound if two chiral centers are formed. So there's one termination step, 2 back to 0. We could also show 2 bromine radicals colliding as well. Lower probability because typically here our, either one of these is fine. Either one may occur in differing probability, but ultimately our major product was already formed in the third propagation step.